Hey guys, welcome back to Reserved Investments on YouTube. And a lot of people are reaching out stating, Sean, you never did a video on the fact that Collectors Holdings, which owns PSA and now WADA Games, has acquired Golden Auctions. We would love to get your take on this. Well, thank you for reminding me multiple times via email and Facebook Messenger, those of you that reached out, some of which I did not respond to. I am, however, gonna release this video for you. So I want to start off by saying I got a little bit sick of talking about all the allegations against WADA Games, certain auction companies, certain individuals in the trade, that I wanted to kind of switch gears a little bit here. I just want you all to know that this is a major talking point going forward. I don't think a lot of people realize this, but the entire antiques and collectibles trade rests on two primary forces. The first one is mass speculation. You can easily, if you are a scrupulous, unethical person, you can easily take some money, you can come into these markets, and you can ignite a fire if you know what you're doing. And the little Timmys, Kimmys, and Poindexters, they'll come running because they have an emotional attachment to these items, and they will defend you to the death. That's what we're seeing right now with the allegations against WADA Games. There are still people out there that are going on collecting forums trying to defend a lot of these individuals, a lot of these companies, stating that, no, it's just fancy marketing. These markets aren't being manipulated. We can't use the word manipulation. Come on. That's what that crazy guy, Sean, with Reserved Investments, wants us to think. This is just fancy marketing. I'm here to tell you guys, it is not fancy marketing. Whenever you have an unregulated market, which is overall with the antiques and collectibles trade, make no mistake, there is a small cabal of investors at the very top that are pulling the strings along, and the little Timmys, Kimmys, and Poindexters are down below dancing on this stage of shit, thinking that they know the ins and outs of these markets. I'm here to tell you that the little Timmys, Kimmys, and Poindexters are eventually going to get slaughtered because they're following and listening to the advice of wrong people. People that do not put their interests first. Now, the second thing that the entire antiques and collectibles trade is governed by outside of speculation is pretty much fear and greed. It's just like Wall Street. People come into these markets, they want to make money. There's people that get scared of a market, they pull back. That's pretty much what governs the trade. Speculation over here and fear and greed. And anytime you unleash those two dynamics in an unregulated market, well, chaos is going to ensue. And that's why if you go all the way back to the 1970s, 1980s, and you start to study these markets in depth, you're going to see everything from weird Beanie Baby price bubbles to coin bubbles to comic book bubbles to Pez dispensers blowing up in value, all these markets going haywire because no one's really overseeing any of them. Nobody really cares if little Timmy pays too much for a video game or a Pez dispenser or a rare coin. Now, when a lot of Timmys pay too much for these items and the market crashes and there's a lot of people that did some wrong, that's when the government gets involved. That's when you start seeing headlines like Graded Coin Market Crashes. X company, X individual forced to pay fine, forced to pay for damages, forced to whatever. That's when that occurs, guys. So make no mistake, those of you that are reaching out, thinking that these allegations against some of these grading companies right now and auction companies are going to go nowhere, I want to assure you, there are people that are starting to take this very seriously. And I can tell you firsthand, the FTC is most likely going to get involved. Now, speaking of that, let's touch on this wonderful headline from July 1st, 2021. The headline reads, Collectors Holdings acquires Golden Auctions. Now, if you don't know who Collectors Holdings is, I'm sure you've all been made familiar with PSA, PCGS coin grading, and of course, WADA Games, because Collectors Holdings now owns WADA Games. Well, now, as of July 1st, they also own Golden Auctions. So a lot of people are reaching out, Sean, give us your opinion on this. I'm just going to be 100% honest, guys. I'm just going to tell you, this completely sucks that in America today, we have pretty much gutted all of our regulations to the point where a grading company can own an auction company. And I want to make this very clear. I am not alleging anything is going wrong or anything is happening unethically between these organizations. I have no knowledge of that. I want to be very clear. But I'm just saying that the fact in the year 2021 that a third-party grading company can now own an auction company, and nobody bats an eye. People just log on to these auction companies and they bid up these items because they think they're going to be a sophisticated investor by paying top dollar for a lot of these pop culture items in the year 2021. Well, I'm sorry, guys. You really got to take a step back and see what's happening in a lot of your beloved collecting categories, whether it's comic books, coins, video games, Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, vintage toys, whatever collecting category we are talking about. Market manipulation to a certain degree is taking place in it at present time. That is the norm. That does not mean it is illegal. I want to make that very clear. There is a fine line between marketing and market manipulation. That I do agree with. So if you're a critic of mine and you're reaching out, hey, Sean, that grading company did nothing wrong. They were just engaged in marketing. I'm sorry. The allegations, if proven true, they show otherwise. That is not just fancy marketing. So now here we are, and we have an auction company that is owned directly by a grading company, or I should say, by the parent holding company of that organization. They're not owned directly by the grading company. That would be false. But they are owned by the holding company that also owns the grading company. And this, in my opinion, we are getting very close to the possibility where it's very easy to blur the line of ethics going forward. And again, I'm not stating that that is happening at all in this case. I am just giving my opinion on how I see this. When you guys reach out and say, hey, Sean, should I be cautious of this? The answer is yes. Can you do anything about it? No, because at the end of the day, they know that a lot of the items that are going up for bid in the auction, they have a known market value. Meaning, obviously, if a certain PSA graded Pokemon card or sports card or Magic the Gathering card, let's say that that particular same item sells in another auction for $50,000 or $60,000, and then it comes into golden auctions. Well, obviously, someone's going to bid that same amount because they know, well, the market value of that particular item is anywhere between $50,000 and $60,000. So therefore, it is a quote-unquote safe bid for me to make on that particular item at present time. But still, the impropriety that could come from this is massive. Make no mistake, guys. And I'm going to do more videos on this. Again, I have nothing against Collectors Universe Holdings. I have nothing against golden auctions. All is what I am hoping is that there are the utmost ethics being employed here, especially in a day and age where we have all these allegations circling around WADA Games, circling around certain top-tier people in the trade, and also auction companies. And that's just my assessment. As a consultant in the trade, I'm going to also state, honestly, I do not personally at present time do business with golden auctions, but that could potentially change. And I want to make that very clear. I'm not stating that I would never bid in any of their auctions, and I want to make that known. I'm just stating that from a perspective of somebody who is acting as a consultant in the overall trade in the year 2021, it almost feels like we're going backwards, where we took a time machine, we're in the early 80s again, with everything that's happening, with third-party grading, with market manipulation, with auctioneer shill bidding, supposedly, and also all this other stuff that's going on. I'm just very, very, very cautious of the overall trade going forward, and some of these prices that are coming out of these auction companies at present time. And I would encourage all of you out there, if you're watching this video, to also at least be just a little bit skeptical, guys, okay? There is a lot of issues in the trade right now in the year 2021, and I honestly wish that the FTC would get involved. I honestly wish that they would start regulating some of the auction houses and some of the grading companies in the overall antiques and collectibles trade. That's all I'm going to say. Your comments are extremely valuable to me. Please let me know what you think below. Thanks, and have a great night.